So we absolutely love comparing League of Legends to other games, and even sports sometimes. It turns out that there's a lot more overlap in skill set than most people tend to think. However, we keep going back to one game in particular, chess. It seems to share so many of the same principles, and when you start comparing the two, it really starts to become clear. When you're first learning chess, there are two things that you learn that are very important at the start of the game. They're called the opening principles. What are they? Develop your pieces and control the center. But why is this important? The main idea is that by moving your pieces out, you can increase the number of squares that are targeted. And by doing this, it makes it harder for the enemy to do what they want, and you put pressure on their pieces. That's why you'll really never see moves like this in the opening, at least not at high level, unless I'm just worse at chess than I thought. Putting a knight on the rim of the board makes it so you only have 3 squares being pressured by it, as opposed to this, which pressures 5. I'm not a chess expert by any means, but that's the gist of it. You'll often see openings like this where both sides are contesting for valuable squares in the middle. Pawns and knights target the center of the board, and bishops have open diagonals to fly down if they wanted to. Without access to the center, it becomes much harder to move the rest of your stuff around and activate your pieces. The point is that chess players value space, a lot. You can't just give the enemy all the room in the world to work with, or you're going to get strangled out. And once those middle squares are taken, you can't just freely move your pieces to start contesting them again. The first person to control the center and keep that control generally comes out the stronger player in the early game. Okay, so enough about chess. What about League? How does this help us? Space in League of Legends is a resource that is important for all 5 roles. Most people probably think of vision and controlling objectives when I say this, which is true, but there's other aspects of it that aren't used nearly as well. Just like in the opening of chess, the opening of League requires use of space in order to not lose, and it can quickly snowball out of control if you don't. To prove how common this issue is, we're going to be using a high gold, low platinum replay, and go over every role in the game and show how the players did not utilize their space to the fullest extent to win. If we take a look at bot lane right away, we'll see that Kai'Sa and Bard are leashing, and then they head towards bottom. It's important to note that they get here first. Let's think about the minion wave like the center of the board, and now we can safely say that they control the center right now. Within a few seconds, however, immediately I already have an issue. Look at how much space there is here. If Ezreal and Sett want to come up and hit the wave, they need to go through a lot of area that Bard supposedly controls right now. However, he lets them move completely for free right back up to the wave without pressuring at all. And even when he connects with a Q, notice how he immediately backs away afterwards. By now, we all know how important level 2 is, and minions are the driving force behind that. If you control the area where the minions are, you by definition control when you get level 2, and when the enemy does as well. Minion waves are the whole reason why anything happens in this game, period. You have to fight for the center here. Not only did you get there first, you outranged the enemy, hard. You have every advantage in the world here, but if you don't know that and don't use it, it doesn't matter. Just look forward and you'll see that Sett actually walks up to the wave to start hitting it, and this should definitely not be allowed, at least not for free. Kai'Sa is also just way too close to Sett's engage range here, so because our bot lane didn't value space highly enough, we're now in a situation where the enemy team actually gets level 2 first and beats a lane that they have no business actually winning against at level 1, all things considered. If you're supposed to be a ranged bully champ that roams around the map, it's really hard to do anything right now in this kind of game state, and just by understanding how to fight over space, that problem could be fixed instantly. Kai'Sa also could have respected Sett's pressure much more, and backed away from the center when she realized that her support wasn't pressuring hard enough, so the fault's on both of them. If we look at mid at the start of the game as well, we're going to see very similar things. Malphite initially plays back a decent amount, probably assuming that Gragas has Q, which is fine, but once he sees that Gragas started W, the threat range of Gragas is extremely small, and Malphite actually outranges now with Q pressure. Basically, Malphite wants to get as much space as possible here, but if we pause right now and ask who's pressuring who, it's clear that neither of them are exerting pressure on each other at all. Both are out of range of each other, and unless you're afraid of the jungler, this just doesn't make sense. When you're fighting over control of the waves, you want to be as close to the enemy as possible without actually being in range to take free damage. Because Malphite has more range, he wants to constantly be in range to Q, but out of range of Gragas' W. This gives you the most amount of room to work with, and if the enemy doesn't know how to play around it, they may not fight you back for that space. Malphite has Q and shield here, and can easily proc mana flow. Why he's giving Gragas this much room to work with just doesn't make sense to me. But now at this point, because he hasn't fought for the space, he gets pressured off and loses the level 2, allowing Gragas to freely control the wave and get a third wave crash off. This is detrimental for junglers fighting over Crab and general control of river, as well as your own lane. We're not trying to argue that Malphite is supposed to get push in this lane at all, but based on how he played, he didn't even try. You need to force the enemy to do the right play in order to win. Don't just let them win without doing the right thing. Being a free lane is the last thing that you want. And let's just go ahead and look at top too. Quinn gets a free push early on in the lane because Gnar just AFKs in a bush, and because of this, she can dictate how the lane goes, right? Well, if she knows that she has an advantage and use that advantage to win space, sure. But she gets level 2, and look at how far away she is. Both laners have access to the wave here, but with the level 2 advantage and ignite, that should not be possible. Even with this advantage, Quinn remains at a distance and doesn't pressure at all. She got control of the center, but failed to translate it into anything meaningful, like getting a third wave recall off, or zoning Gnar of CS. In all three lanes, we literally saw the exact same thing at level 1. Someone is just clearly not using their space advantage, and the other person isn't getting punished for not having one. This isn't just at level 1 either, we see this constantly throughout the game no matter what. Why are Bard and Kai'Sa at their backline minions when they have full vision of both laners and aren't being threatened? I have no idea. Sett shouldn't be allowed to walk up without taking damage, but clearly that doesn't happen except for one Kai'Sa Q. Okay, so all the jungle mains are probably thinking, how does this apply to me, and don't worry, we've got you covered. Controlling space doesn't come in the form of minion waves, but rather location on the map. When Jarvan goes for this bot gank, he reveals a Mumu and a recalling Sett as he walks into river. At this point, you have to consider that the area in which you allow a Mumu to travel in is very important. If you walk up and force a Mumu to enter in his jungle like this, then you gain access to a lot of area and also protect your mid laner, who at this point is pushing in and could get ganked soon. However, Jarvan concedes space, even though he really has no reason to. With a pushing mid, he would be fine to take a 1v1 or 2v2. By going to Krugs, not only does he give a Mumu access to mid if he wants it, he could also steal away Jarvan's raptors in the meantime. I know he doesn't get the kill here, but if he played it better and moved in front of Gragas before he could E, he could easily block the escape and wind up with a free kill. Because Jarvan just completely concedes and basically gives a Mumu all of this area for free, he really limits the plays he can look for and prevent. Not just letting junglers walk around the map for free helps to prevent a lot of ganks, and he easily could have shifted the visual to look something more like this. In this way, we can think about the overall map like a chessboard. You just want more room to be able to maneuver, and less room for the enemy to do so. If we think about how many squares black controls in this game versus white, the reasoning behind why space in chess and in jungle, as well as other roles, should make perfect sense. In a way, what Jarvan just did is basically equivalent to playing how the black pieces did in our example moments before, where they let the opponent control a ton of area and walk all over them. Space is one of those things that's an almost abstract concept, but hopefully these examples have gotten you to think a bit more about why it matters and how you're not utilizing it to its fullest potential. There are plenty more examples in this game that we could go over, as there are always constant mistakes, but the biggest thing is to actively think about your space as a resource and identify how you can be using it better. Remember, if you want to improve fast and get the rank you've always wanted, then check out SkillCapped.com. It's the only service that offers an improvement guarantee. If you don't climb at least 5 divisions while actively using SkillCapped, you can claim a refund. Check us out, link in the description below. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll catch you in the next one.